training.
About to go 15 rounds. You old school, y'all. I love that style. Love that style.
Oh yeah, he definitely top. False comparison. Defense too a little, man. But what it was is that I was at Tony Harris using angle on me and slide on the side door. I should have cut the ring off a little better. You know, my feet work out just more straight instead of using angles myself. So other than that, man, you know, we've been working on our footwork, making sure that these guys can't move with a dance circle around me.
Okay. So you see this fight more of a chess match, a little bit of...
Oh, yeah. It's definitely going to be more of a mind game in there than the physical strength for you. I mean, it's going to be definitely a mind game.
Okay. Is there anyone else? I mean, not looking past him, but is there anyone... Since there's so much going on at 154, anybody else on your hit list?
Oh, yeah. Most definitely, man. This is the card to display the 154-pound talent. So, you know, we definitely want Lara. We definitely want Jermell Charlo, winner of that fight with Lubin. So, you know, one of those guys, Antero Boucher, he comes up with upset.
Give me predictions on the two fights, Charlo Lubin.
For the Charlo fight, I'm going to have to go with Charlo because it is not to say that fight's not 50-50 because we really don't know what Lubin is doing. This is his first time on a stage like this, and no telling, man, if he go out there and you know, show off. So, but as far as experience and support, as far as him, Charlo being there, I'm going to go with Charlo. And with the Lara fight, I don't think Terrell Boucher is quite on Lara level right now, and I feel like Lara is going to take that fight.
Okay. Anything else you want the fans to know about this fight, or anything else on your mind before I let you go, man?
Oh, yeah, man, just know that, like I said, this is a display for the 154-pounders Saturday night. And y'all talk to the one that's right now, it's going to be on top.
All right, Jared Hurry, y'all. Thanks, man.
You didn't pass, Garrett?
Huh?
You didn't pass today?
Nah, man. I just pulled up, man. I just got in town, so I only got no shoes.
Oh, yeah. I noticed you took off the samples right now. Okay.
Yeah. I don't have no shoes.
No
enough.
Shoes.
Yeah.
Porter Hernandez with the local of Southwest Vikings here with Jared Hurd. So, Jared, you're here at the same time, Austin. Is this kind of awkward?
Nah, man. You know, I've seen Austin a couple times and outside the gym. You know what I'm saying? It's no type of nothing personal. He knows business and respect.
You guys have been, for the most part, pretty respectful of each other's skills.
Right.
Why is it important for you to have this fight, and why did you ask for it?
Because, you know, I want to be the best. In order to be the best, you got to beat the best. And I feel like Austin Charles is one of the guys that even though he has three losses on the top level competition, in order to fight on the top level competition, you got to get past a guy like Austin Trump. So I feel like this fight right here will take me there.
What would a win over him mean to you?
Everything, man. And it'd be more important if I get a stoppage because within those three losses, you know, it was all title fights, but he never been stopped. He been put down on the canvas to get back up to finish the fight. So, you know, getting a stoppage would separate me from, you know, those other three champions. And, you know, I want to show that I'm much better than him.
You mentioned just pulling up. What was the travel delay about? What happened there?
The train, man. You know, the train is supposed to be here around 12 something to end up. We end up getting here like around 1:20, something like that. So that's the reason why we're a little late. And our bags are in the car still, so we didn't have any chance to pack that.
I know the feeling, bro.
Yeah.
This is your first defense of the title. What's it like to defend it against someone with such a resume like Trout?
Like I said, man, this is my second time fighting here in New York. And they always show me love, and to defend my title here in Brooklyn, man, it's an honor, man. And Sword Nation is definitely going to be in the house. I just can't wait to put on the show.
Best of luck.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Where'd you take the train from?
Maryland.
Do you fly ever?
Yeah, we do fly, but you know,
I just know some cats are afraid of planes. So.
Oh, nah, I'm getting on the plane.
Swift, he said you disrespected his media workout by coming at the same time. How do you feel about that?
To get a peek. Any truth in that? You think you're ruffling his feathers?
Nah, man, it's not that. It's that this is when Ryan sent me and that's when we come in and work out, so I had to do it.
Is there anything that you did kind of get a look at, or you focus on your own thing?
Nah, man, like I said, I already seen, I watched enough tape of Austin, and you know, many people don't know, I actually been in the ring with Austin Trump before, so, I mean, you know, there's nothing that I don't need to see or anything like that. We got to get
And how was that? Give us a little insight on, you know, what kind of sparring sessions you guys had. How was it, competitive? You feel like you had the edge?
I mean, you know, you can't really talk too much about the sparring sessions. We only did two rounds together. Okay. And, you know, those were basically the filling out rounds, so it wasn't much action, man. But, you know, like I said, I'm just familiar with Austin Trout, and nothing really went too much on the sparring session. But, you know, we won't see what happens.
You're the young champ. He's the, you know, the crafty veteran. How much of that plays into this? It's kind of a crossroads fight. Do you look at it like that, or are you taking him like a prime fighter?
Oh, yeah. Me being the younger fighter, I definitely think it plays a part. I feel like Austin Trout in his last two fights were Lara and compared to his fight against Charlo, yeah. And compared to his fight before Canelo and Cotto and guys, he's a little flatter than he used to be. Like his age getting to a little bit. I wouldn't say it's a big factor, but he had his moments used to. I feel like in those last fights. But, you know, we're not going to say that that's the reason. I know he's trained hard for the fight. I know he's going to be big, so we're going to see what he do.
Was there any kind of fandom back when you were coming up and he was, you know, that it guy? Is it, are you fighting somebody that you admired a little bit? Or?
Yeah, man, we was always rooting for Austin, you know. But like I said, to be honest with you, I used to watch him on TV all the time when he won his title. I fight with Cotto, I was rooting for him.
Yeah.
You know, we was always rooting for Austin, man. But like I said, it's just respected. You know, he's a respectful guy, enough person in this business that he's in with.
You mentioned being in the ring with him. How long ago was that, and what fight camps were you each getting ready for back then?
Well, that was a little while ago. That was before my TV debut, so I say back in 2015. It was only like 2 rounds.
So I asked him this question. Is there a parallel between his fight with Miguel Cotto and your fight with him now? Do you feel you're in the role that he was against Miguel Cotto, now against him?
Yeah, kind of. It's almost like he's defending his title and, you know,